11:08 a.m. And again, you don't hear passwords, they messing with it. What was that? The bar let me see you. And thank you.
8:15 a.m.
Thank you. Clear as a bell. Y'all turn that machine back to that high pitch back up. Lower thank you. You don't stop. Even when they move, you don't stop. And it is. Podcast coming soon. I should be going to get more powder. Dope. In a moment. I'm hearing this and say, oh yeah, move them next door.
biggest income. 11:31.
Songs back to back, then a hard drum. I mean, drum. Some more coming.
Well, our pastor never did that. So when it came to the baptism of the Holy Spirit,
divine healing, you're God.
You're God. So that started a church.
Did you become a Pentecostal church, or was it a transition?
It was more of a transition church, learning about the Holy Spirit, learning about the baptism. That's when I started listening. This was in the 60s, Brother Slatter. And I started listening to your radio program, and it's 15 minutes a day. WTJH.
Yeah.
And then we started going to some Pentecostal services. We didn't know where to start. But we had to start with your, and I think, Brother Long, there are a lot of people who want to know how to start. We know the Holy Spirit's working in our lives. What does that mean? How does that look?
How many of y'all were there?
Oh, there were probably 20 of us.
So you started a church.
Started a little church, and then it began to grow. And God was giving, because he never lost that zeal and passion for souls.
Right. And we went off and got the church left.
Pardon? The church we left wound up holding. But when I was little, this Baptist pastor believed in me. He'd bring me up, and he would pray for sick. He'd bring me up with Stanley when I was 11 years old. And have been praying for people with him.
About because you had been healed.
Because I had been healed. We were operating in a limited knowledge.
I'll guarantee you that people got healed, didn't they?
Yes, they were.
When I was at the Southern Baptist Theological Seminary in Louisville, Kentucky, I mean, the hub of Southern Baptist.
Lord Jesus, thank you.
I had a professor, I won't say his name, but if I did, I probably didn't find it, but I was the only Pentecostal in my cohort, and he had been a missionary on a foreign field, and he said, just between you and me, he said, I am not a cessationist. He said, the institution is, but I'm not. He said, I cannot deny what I've seen on foreign missions, what I've seen the Holy Spirit do. He said, I cannot deny that. He said,
what did he say?
He said, you know, he said, I don't understand it all, but he said, I value you in the Pentecostal movement, and I know it's real. And he said, his statistic, he said, I know there's 500 million Pentecostals out there, and he said, I can't deny the movement of the Holy Spirit in these days.
11:35.
If your faith is in Christ and you're pursuing what he wants you to pursue, He will bring you to the baptism of the Holy Spirit, but as a Pentecostal, you better not leave behind what you had initially. And that's what we've done as a Pentecostal movement.
See, I think that was one thing our pastor didn't tell us against.
Yeah.
He didn't know to tell us for. So he wasn't limiting God. Would it be a fair statement to say the biggest thing that hinders the Holy Spirit from working in our lives is us?
Of course, but again, if you're brought up in a tradition that teaches you not to believe in the work of the Holy Spirit, whether you're a Pentecostal telling believers you can't have victory over sin until you're baptized with the Holy Spirit, or you're a
requisite that you told many times, but you took that last drink of alcohol.
Yeah.
Then
you bet. I did.
And what happened?
Well, it wasn't just the last drink. It was the last line of cocaine. It was the last rolling up the joints that I did.
Saved now for several weeks.
I've been saved for several weeks, and these things dropped off little by little. And within 90 days, the externals that had been so hurtful and mounting to such a degree, from smoking the two packs a day and the Copenhagen and the pills and all the rest of it, those externals were eliminated. And it was another 3 months after that before I was baptized with the Holy Spirit.
But the Spirit of God worked in your heart and life during that period.
That's the only one who could have delivered me from that. And every single born-again believer has that capability. That's what we need to teach.
And you were delivered from nicotine. A dear lady sitting very close to you in church on a Sunday morning.
That is true. I came into the presence of a Pentecostal denomination, but I wasn't baptized with the Holy Spirit.
At that time?
No, it took another 3 months before I was actually baptized, but it was that day that the work of the Holy Spirit that I received in salvation manifested itself in freedom from cigarettes. So, don't tell people what the Holy Spirit cannot do in that. Don't do that. He's not limited. He's only limited by our faith. And when we, as Pentecostals, say, well, he doesn't do that until you're baptized, we're limiting people. We're hurting people. And when we tell people the Holy Spirit doesn't do that anymore, we're hurting people. And we're hurting the work of God.
I hope this
is built. Stop.
I hope this built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I will not trust the sweetest flame, but only me on that dear name.
Yeah.
On Christ the solid rock I stand. All else is sinking sand. All else is sinking sand. When the person gets saved, what our dear brother wrote some 300, 400 years ago, it holds true in their life immediately when they hit on the Christ.
Well, on that spring day of 1966, under that Oral Roberts tent meeting, when I was healed, not one member of my family was baptized with the Holy Ghost. Not one. But we knew that God could do something. But we didn't know what he was going to do or how he was going to do. But we were open to letting him move in our lives.
Right. So when were you baptized with the Holy Spirit? You were saying that at an age you don't even understand because it was so young.
Yeah.
But your church then transitioned from a Baptist church. What did you encounter?
I actually got baptized with the Holy Spirit, with the initial evidence of speaking in tongues, at age 13, 2 years later.
Yeah.
It took that long. And it was funny because I was one of those that, I'm sure you preached in the church many times. It was a large church in Atlanta that you used to preach in. Yeah, the old Assembly of God. I went to the altar seeking the baptism of the Holy Ghost. I must have been probably at that time 12. And I'm praying, God, fill me with the Holy Ghost. Fill me with the Holy Ghost. Yeah, all you know how to do is beg. That's all we knew how to do at the time. And the more you beg, the better you beg, the quicker God's going to move in your life. That's all we knew. We were ignorant. But our ignorance was innocent and pure towards God. It is still ignorance.
I heard Brother Ian's Father, he was preaching in Africa. They were having a lot of people filled with the Holy Spirit. Actually, one of the missionaries told me that most all of the people baptized with the Holy Spirit.
He's waving at us, you're going to have to
talk. We'll be right back.
At this particular time, as you can see, we are studying the Great Book of Romans. It is the story of the New Covenant, and it is, I think, single most important material on the face of the earth. I believe that this book, some 650 pages of the Book of Romans, will help you to understand the New Covenant, the message of the cross. What Jesus there did for us has nothing else will. It sells normally for $40, on sale for just $20 plus shipping and handling. Every believer needs to understand what the New Covenant is. Every believer needs to understand the message of the cross. This will help you to understand it, I think, as never before. And this is Jesus where you're saying, I am waiting for your call.
For more information on this offer, go to shopjsm.org.
For me,
what was solid and complete, and the working of the Holy Spirit after salvation.
11:47 a.m.
Guiding me, helping me understand Scripture, helping me to understand what the main design. I didn't have a lot of teacher. I didn't know all my friends from. And so a lot of the things that I was learning was just internal. And then I would watch you from it. I'd watch studying the Word. I'd watch the weekly telecast after I found it and then came into a church. But all of the work that was being done was just dynamic to me. So when I got centered in the Pentecostal church and they started talking about, well, you can't have this until you're baptized with the Holy Spirit, I'm kind of thinking, no, that's not right. And theologically, it's been the message of the cross that has opened up the reality of what the Holy Spirit does in salvation. And let's never forget or demean what he wants to do when he fills us with the Holy Spirit for the purpose of ministry. And so instead of just one or the other, let's have them both. And faith is what operates all the work of the Holy Spirit.
It's for every believer. Let's be clear, because some would hear you and say, well, it's for ministry, and they're going to think and say, well, I'm not going to stand behind a pulpit. No, this is for every single believer, talking about the baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Exactly.
Now, I'll just interject this a long time ago. In fact, the first meeting that I can think of that Dad went out to preach that I was there with him when his family was in Georgia. And he preached on the Holy Spirit and prayed for people. And I remember this happening. They were all so excited because one particular brother was filled. Now, when I say excited, I mean, half the church, they were just jumping and shouting. Wiggling and shouting. Come to find out, this man was an elder in the church. He had been saved for decades, and he had been seeking the baptism of the Holy Spirit for that long. And he just could not be filled. It just wasn't happening. But in that service, he was filled with the Spirit. And that church, the thoughts were just going right into the Lord. It was unbelievable to see.
Yes, sir. The Lord is spirit of sense and of spirit. If you're saying, yes, you have the Holy Spirit, but not the baptism of the Holy Spirit unless you have been filled. And the Lord wants to fill you. He wants you to have it. And we're going to pray in just a few moments. And you will hear, sense, feel words that are not English or any other language that you learn in school on your mom's knee. And what you're hearing is the Holy Spirit giving the utterance. He won't speak for you. He won't do anything for you. He wants you to be filled. You're the one who needs to be filled. And those words that you hear, start speaking them. Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Those words that you hear in your spirit, start speaking them right now as we will pray for you. The Lord wants to save you. He loves you.
Yes.
Praise God. He wants you to have the mighty baptism with the Holy Spirit.
said the words that you hear in your own heart right now. Start speaking them. Start saying them. The Holy Spirit won't force you. He won't say the part. He'll give the utterance. But he will not do the speaking. That's you. Be filled with the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
As the song says, come Holy Spirit, move on me. By your anointing, set me free. Pour out the wine on this thirsty heart of mine. Come, Holy Spirit, move on me.
Come, Holy Spirit, move on me.
By your
anointing, set me free. Pour out the wine on this thirsty heart of mine. Come, Holy Spirit. And he'll move on you. He's doing it. He's doing it right now. Praise God. Glory to God. And don't be ashamed to tell somebody that you've been baptized with the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And there's nothing like it other than salvation.
Go ahead. What I was just simply going to say is that you don't have to be a pastor.
No.
Speak to us on a set or in front of a group, I'd have to come live with you for a while because that's just not what I'm going to do. But
that's all right. Please go ahead and do what you said.
But what I wanted to share with the people was as a mom baptized with the Holy Spirit, she's been responsible for raising four children, all of which are doing work of God. In the ministry, Joseph, Grace, Rachel, Joy, all four of them. And this is an anointing that rests under her that I don't have. But it's for service. It's for bringing people into the knowledge and recognition of Christ.
Yes.
And God's given her that.
Yes.
But we run out of time. Thank you for having me.
No, sir.
Yes. The Book of Romans is, I think, one of the greatest books in the entire general Word of God. And it might just be the greatest. These two books that we're offering, I hope you understand it, I think, a little better. This one is entitled, God's Answer to Fear, Depression, and Discouragement. Every believer needs this. Every Christian needs to read this as well. Now, these are $15 each.
Church, read the book of Acts and get ready.
Opera, subtitled Songs About the Holy Spirit. Every song on it is about the Holy Spirit. Order today.
Join Family Worship Center pastors as they minister in a city near you.
You say I was gonna watch.
Let me turn back, Lord.
I was just Francis and that first matter. We were both just kids. She would tell me over and over again, as if though she didn't have much more time to tell me. In reality, she didn't, because God called her home for a short time. Jim, as you would say, God is a big God. And I don't mean matter-of-factly, but I mean she would tell me with power and strength. When you ask for his help, ask big.
Well, yes, and thank you.
I'll never forget it. She would tell me the Holy Spirit.
Thank you for passing.
Will walk with you. Give him his way. Don't lead him. Let him lead you. I didn't know how valuable those words were, but they took root and they grew. And that's what we're here today for, is to be led by the Holy Spirit. There's a little chorus that came out of the Great Cares Hype movement that said, come, Holy Spirit, yes, I need thee.
12:02 p.m.
Bomb with Gideon, and as he's singing it, the group can help him if they like, but I want you, as he sings just a verse and a chorus, I want you to slip up your hand if you need that touch from heaven. And I want you to let the bomb, which means medicine, the medicine of Gideon, and that's Jesus, to come and touch your heart and touch your life. I have a dear friend that's ill this afternoon in a hotel here in town, and I'm believing God that Jesus is going to go into that room and going to touch him with his mighty finger and his power. And as John sings it, you have a television if you need healing in your living rooms, family rooms, motel, or maybe you don't think anyone else cares. God does. And let him come in where you are. Just close your eyes and lift that hand up if you need that touch. Sing it, John, please.
Sometimes the way is weary.
Lord, thank you.
And just let the Lord have his way all over this place. Where there